Hello everybody, this is Maniac for Bricks, and I am here today with set number 5764, the Rescue Robot from LEGO Creator. This set is ages 7 to 12, has 149 pieces, includes a light brick. It has three different models that you can build in the same set, although you have to build one model at a time. And this was released in 2011. This was available originally for the price of $16.99 in US dollars. Although, by now it's obviously obsolete. So, let's take a closer look at this set now, starting with the box. The box you may see on its sides has some poor condition to it, just from when I bought it. But, it's got a pretty massive size for a small priced set. And even looking at the contents inside of this, it feels like a much larger box than it really needed to be. Obviously, on the front you can see the proud standing Rescue Robot. It also shows you on the top corner the light brick, which is the special function of the set, probably the most important of any of the functions. On the bottom you get to see the other two models you can build with the set. Over here we get to see the piece count for everything in the set. A little tiny to see on that side, though. I also wanted to mention on the front, they show you batteries included, so that when you are opening the set for the first time, you can use the light brick right out of the box. On this side, I'd like to mention that they show the robots on that side, kind of in similar style to the front. You can also see everything a little bit better scaled on this side, on the back. So now we'll take a look at some of the other contents. Inside the box, you get two pairs of instruction booklets, which have binding on the longer side. On this side, there's stapled binding. And I really point that out because it's unusual compared to most instruction booklets in terms of its resolution. Now you can see with this one, they have the instructions bent, because the way I found them in the box, as I opened it, they were actually coiled together, kind of like this. And it was kind of a sloppy thing to do with them, trying to make it a little bit smaller to fit in there, but I had to a little bit bend it out of shape in order to read the instructions carefully. As you can see, the robot one is actually lined up pretty well that way. So, as you can see, we have one instruction booklet for the main model, the Rescue Robot. And although we don't have names for the other two models, we have them shown in the same instruction booklet. The instructions inside are pretty basic in terms of creator style, and I won't go through every last step, but it's the same kind of style for the instructions in terms of color and setup as you would see in nowadays creator sets. On the back of the instructions on this one, you can see it shows the light brick. It also shows 2011, the LEGO group in the bottom corner, and does not have any sort of back page, just has the last step of that model. This one, on the other hand, has a few back pages. It shows a light brick there for the final step. It shows one page for the piece count. The other page shows you some of the other LEGO Creator sets from 2011. And I've already reviewed the log cabin in case you want to see that review. It also shows you sideways the LEGO Creator website with the backslash of designers. So it shows you some interesting models on the website for modifying your LEGO Creator sets as well as building your original stuff. You also have a LEGO Club advertisement and the WinKid on the back. This set comes packaged in two bags. One is a small bag, about this size, and has a lot of your smaller pieces in various colors. Then we have a larger bag, which is about this size, and it carries a lot of larger pieces, some of your ball joints, the more unique elements, and even the light brick itself. Now we'll take a look at some of the extra pieces in this set. We have several cheese wedges, or one-by-one slopes, in various colors, from red to yellow to black. That's kind of like the German colors, aren't they? Is that why LEGO made the set in this color scheme? Anyways, I'm just joking around. We also have some 1x1 round plates in trans yellow and in black. We have a black Technic pin. We have a 1x2 black plate. We have a white lever base with the black handle. And we have a 1x1 flat tile in dark bluish gray. We also have this little piece, which was inserted into the light brick when it was initially in the package. This is a simple thing that you just remove in order to allow the light brick to work. Otherwise, it would have prevented any light from showing as the package was moved about. Keep in mind that all these extra pieces are ones that are used with the rescue robot after assembly. So, any combination of these pieces can also be used with other models that are built in this set. So let's take a closer look at the set now. So here we have the main model of the set. This is the rescue robot. This is the one that takes the most amount of pieces and has probably the most building of any of these three models. Although it's hard to say because a lot of these apparently have similar, you know, uses of pieces. We'll find out more about that as we go through the other models. This is the first one that I'm reviewing, since it is the main one from the set. So, I may, have different information as I build the other models later. As you can see, this model has a basic scheme between gray, dark bluish gray, red, yellow, and black. The yellow serves as more of the accent, and the dark bluish gray, as well as light bluish gray, serves as more the mechanical and basic parts. As we look towards the back of it, you can see this peculiar Technic piece put along the back. This is enabled so that all the structure inside of here stays together. It's a similar technique we've seen with other LEGO sets, and I actually like it. It may not look too great for the robot from the back, but it actually serves a good purpose for any LEGO model. I remember seeing a similar technique like that made in the 2008 castle set Dwarves Mine. As you can see, we can turn the head of the robot back and forth, but it doesn't have a lot of motion. The motion is mainly stopped by the studs next to it on the same area. So it doesn't really have much motion, but you can still move it about as if it is, you know, looking for something. It has a small lever on this side, which I'll presume to be either its operator's remote or maybe some kind of headset, depending on how you want to use this robot. The robot has similar functions on both sides of its body. It is built in a symmetric form, although the feet are actually, the hands and the feet are actually built opposite of each other. They are split down the middle, symmetrical. We have a combination of ball joints for the shoulders as well as the hips. And then for the arms, we have two hinge pieces used to keep it nice and sturdy. Then we also have some fingers that can move about, also on hinges. You can have him with a little thumbs up because his thumb is permanently in that place. He may have a little bit of use for grasping things, but considering there's no other fingers on the other side to interlock, it may not work too well for grabbing things. Although it is nice to have that effect. To make it look like it is. You can also see he has some kind of, I'm going to presume, a laser blaster underneath, or maybe some kind of flashlight, because he's a rescue robot. Perhaps he's more of a thing for searching around. A similar thing is put on the other side. Now for the legs, as you can see at the hip, we can balance him on the ball joints, and it seems to do pretty well. You can put him in different poses. There we go. Just getting his balance. Now on this side, you can also have... Ooh, seems to be a problem. Yeah, I've had this happen a few times when playing with this, but apparently there's a small problem with the joints towards the ankle. It's hard to move the ankle joints in a way that won't make this fall apart, and I think a little adjustment of pieces might help with that. So you'll have to move it more with two hands instead of one, because of the fixed joints, it might just pop off. We can get a little bit better on the... Oh, no, we can't. Apparently did the same on the other side. I'm not really sure what's on the bottom of the robot's feet, but I'm going to presume there's some sort of jetpacks. Or, again, there could be some sort of flashlights. You can see there's a little bit of trans yellow in there. So, makes it interesting. So there we have the main model. I think it's a pretty cool build. It had a lot of good uses of pieces. I would have to say, though, the ankles need a little bit of fixing up. Perhaps it doesn't need the double joints for it, although I do understand the idea of it being sturdy and holding together. It might be too much force between the parts, and therefore would cause things to fall apart by accident. It also would have been nice if there was a small piece put inside of here, maybe a 2x2 plate, just to raise the head a little bit and you can have more motion back and forth. Oh, did I forget about the main feature? Well, turning the lights off, now we can go to the main part, which has the light brick. Ah, very nice. It seems to work out very well. And it's not the light brick itself that makes the yellow. It's actually the trans clear piece. It's the trans pieces in front of it. The second model we can build is a robot, which only has one hand and then the other hand is kind of like a gun, which is pretty cool looking. This one comes from the second instruction book, where you get two of the models to build in the same book, therefore taking less steps and probably less difficulty to build it. And scissors not included, I just found that to be kind of funny to put the scissors in his hand as a holdable object. Because the arms don't actually, the fingers don't actually go out too far to put like a minifigure in there. It could fit, but it would take some work. So let's look at this robot that we have. He's got a nice style to him. His legs are a little bit similar to the first robot we first saw. The back of this one doesn't really look that great either, because, you know, we got all those flat pieces and nothing really detailed or anything. Just kind of, you know, this is mostly built this way, then flipped up this, with all the other arms and legs and head, you know, attached separately. The wings, I guess these are wings, can move up and down, and they can move pretty far in, but they would also prevent the head from moving much. So you do have that little problem of some parts interfering with each other during play. But it still has a lot of cool design. I like the way the colors are used throughout this one. It seems well balanced. Well, except for the yellow, because there's not much yellow in the set. But between the black, the red, and the gray, it seems like a good mix of them. As I mentioned, we have one hand with four fingers, and you could try to clench a minifigure in there. Let me see if I can throw my sick fig in there. It takes a little bit of work. See, it doesn't really close all the way, and might actually be a little hard to fit a minifigure in there. If you lift up a leg, you could probably get a little bit better, as if he's trying to spring free of his grasp. Possibly. I like how the head can turn back and forth, and again, has as much mobility as, you know, as the wings allow. These are put onto ball joints once again, and I didn't mean to, didn't mean to knock that off. This doesn't really interfere too much with the wings. You still got a lot of motion around this way. The gun, on the other hand, is a little larger, so it will interfere with the wings for quite a bit. And this is a neat little gun. I like the way this is designed. A little poor on the bottom, though, because it's just easy to pop off. Although it would make it a little bit better if you wanted to use it for something else. I realize with the light in this light brick, it's actually yellow. So, I was wrong before when I said that, oh, it's just the trans yellow pieces that make it look yellow. Sometimes it does, but in this case, it actually is yellow. Now we'll take a look at the light with our little gun. Pew! Pew, pew, pew! Nice. Let's see it from this way so you can see how well it lights up against a wall. You can see the light following it. And it does go through the trans yellow pieces. Got a little bit of detail on there too. Some chrome pieces around it. Okay, we're back to the light. So, like I said earlier, these legs are kind of similar from the first robot, because they have well, similar joints, obviously, but they also have that kind of sideways stance on them. So you can't actually move the knees or anything forward. You just have him kind of in a battle position like that. Like he's holding his ground. So as far as making a walking motion with this figure, just like the last one, a little bit difficult. But this one does hold up a little bit better as far as the legs. I think it actually does a better job of construction there, so it doesn't, you know, keep popping off as you try to make them work. This is best as I could do for some kind of walking motion. Just kind of goofy in that way. So, neat looking robot. Let's see about our third build. So last but not least, we have the beginner's design. This is some sort of robotic cat, if I'm guessing it correctly. This is also from the same book as the robot, and it is the last one that is built in that same booklet. The first thing that strikes me about this, that makes me think it's a cat, is how it's posed. Now you can notice the legs in the back are much larger than the legs in the front. So as far as fitting all the legs onto one surface flat, this is pretty much the pose you're going to get. And that's one thing I don't like about it, is how limited it is in posability. I mean, yeah, you have the ball joints, but if you're going to have all four legs down, this is the best way and the only way you can really do it. Otherwise, the front two would be up in the air. So on the back, you can see we got this hinged tail. It has a few sets of hinges so you can move it around, make it waving, which is pretty cool. You can even move it on the antenna and on this piece, although it is a little bit on the fragile side, so just be careful moving it around. I like the pose of this one, so you can have it as if it's looking for something or it's creeping up on something. You can move the head around, and you can almost move it all the way back. You can easily turn it so it doesn't interfere with any other parts of it, although if you have the head down, you can only move it so far. The head, I'm not really sure if the yellow on these two sides are the eyes, or if it just has one large eye in the middle that just kind of shines like that. Let's see if we can put it against the background. There it is. Set my fingers in the way, because it's a little hard to reach this without getting your finger in the way. There it is. You can spot mice pretty clearly in the dark with that. I do like how the head is made, but it could have been a little bit higher, just so it's not too forward, and, you know, it could probably do better positioning in that if it was a little bit up more and actually more on this turntable. Alright, so as far as the legs, well, there's not much underneath to really see, and if I hold it up like this, you can see it looks kind of awkward with its head out. Like I said before, the body seems a little bit on the, you know, the very sloped side, so it's not really rounded to look like a cat. Again, I'm assuming this is a robot because there's a lot to it that doesn't seem very natural to a cat. Although I do like how the yellow is used around here as if it's like a collar, I'm assuming. But it's okay for a beginner model, you know, something you could easily build and just get a little bit of a hang of, you know, posing it and moving around parts and things. But I will have to say, in overall, my favorite is between the first and second models we looked at. I can't really tell which one I like better. I probably like the first one better because it has better movements and just a little bit stylish. Although I do like the second one's style. But it does have problems with, you know, the arms being so close to the wings and the body. And, you know, in the first one, I didn't like how it was close, you know, how the legs were working, because they had a tendency to fall off. So if there's a mishmash between them, maybe that would make the best of the Rescue Robot set. But it was still a cool set to look at. It was great to have this available. So thank you for watching this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Be sure to check out my Bricklink store for all the different kinds of parts you may need for building with LEGO. And we will see you next time with more LEGO set reviews. Oh, and one last note from this review. This particular model has a lot of extra pieces that weren't used and, well, were used from other models. But as far as the extra pieces we looked at in the very beginning after building the first one, they didn't really change that much from model to model. The only thing that was needed from that little pile was the 1x2 plate. And you could look back in the beginning to see how those extra pieces were. I don't know if they have it separated out on BrickLink or anything like that, because I know Creator, you know, tends to use extra pieces and you can't really tell which are extra. But thank you for watching this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time with more LEGO videos. Just thought I'd throw that in.